Peter, you were the one who told Tom Tucker to try all that nonsense on TV? You realize you cost that man his job.
Well, how was I supposed to know? Katie Couric went on TV and stuck a tube up her butt and they threw her a parade.
That was a colonoscopy.
This is kind of your fault, you know. I mean, you're the one who was drooling over that Dallas-Portland. I was just trying to get that guy off the air.
Peter, that's ridiculous. He's just some pretty boy who doesn't mean anything. It's like when you watch Mad Men for that chick you said was like a fat me.
I said a young fat you.
The point is, you've ruined that man's life.
You're right. Poor Tom. Thanks to me, he's fallen even further than Charlie Rose.
Today on CBS This Morning, we'll be talking about how much sleep you need to not be drunk from the night before.
That's not what we're talking about.
That's what I'm talking about.
What the hell do you want?
I'm here to say I'm sorry about what happened. Let me make it up to you. I'm the one who made you lose your job. I'll find you a new one.
Don't bother. I'm washed up. Everyone saw what I did. And besides, I can't do anything else. I was born to be a newsman. This just out, me!
That happened? Is that for real? That's nuts. But still, I want to help you get back on your feet.
Go home, Peter. You've already done enough. Thanks to you, it's over for me. Like Billy Zane.
Billy, you're through. You haven't done anything in 10 years.
Yes, I have. I was in those electronic cigarette commercials.
That was Steven Dorff.
Oh.
Sorry I let you down, Tom.
Oh, my God! Look! Up on the roof!
Holy crap! Doritos Tacos is only for a limited time? And oh, no! Tom Tucker's gonna jump! Tom, I got here as fast as I could. So what's going on?
It's over for me, Peter. If I can't anchor the local news, I have no reason to live.
Look, Tom, before you do anything crazy, you should know one thing. I have that exact same bathrobe.
Hey, Tom, the camera's gonna be on you in a second. Before you jump, could you just hand me this microphone? Like you're passing me the torch?
What the hell are you doing here?
What am I doing? Getting an interview with a crazed jumper on the brink of suicide. This is huge!
Wait a second. You heard wrong, Dallas. There's a jumper here, but it ain't Tom. It's me.
What?
That's right. Tom was just trying to talk me down. And if there's a news story here, the only one I'm giving it to is Tom Tucker. Here.
Roll it. Good evening, Quahog. This is Tom Tucker atop a roof where a local crazy person is preparing to end it all.
Bonnie, Tom Tucker's back on the news.
Oh, here you are. Tom Tucker's back.
I know.
Honey, I'm back on TV.
No, Billy, that's Tom Tucker.
Oh.
What's going on?
Don't worry about it. Just get those pants off.
Oh, your hair is amazing.
Tell us, crazy person, why are you doing all this?
I'll tell you why. I'm doing this because I ruined a guy's life, and I feel awful about it. It's the only thing I can think of to make things right.
Well, whoever this guy is, I'm sure he appreciates what you're trying to do for him. I think I speak for all our viewers when I say, don't do this. Please, come down off this ledge with me.
You got it. If that's what the most trusted newsman in Quahog wants. Ah! Pigeon! Ah! It's fine. He landed on people.
Well, I'm glad your crazy stunt worked out and Tom Tucker is back at Channel 5.
Yeah, apparently when he interviewed me up on that roof, the ratings were so huge, they made him anchor again.
That's great to hear because
Lois! Lois!
Is somebody calling my name?
Lois!
I don't think so, no.
Lois, I'm rich!
Now I think I do hear something. I should probably go see what he wants. I know I'm a nerd, but I have like a thing for rich guys.
Oh boy, she's getting in his helicopter.
Fadoo, 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 fadoo.
Well, I'm big enough to admit when I'm wrong.